still alive, so that's progress.
Upon her enemies.
Test awaits. Descends to the mass.
Shroud yourself in the blackest night.
Rise again. A dark.
Trust your secrets to the night.
Almost there. I will not fail you, my lady. This must be the last step. I need to pray. Only by Lady Shah's grace did we even make it this far.
Nothing. Shadowheart continues her prayer in silence.
All right. No need to dash in ahead of me. I'm ready. Nothing. Just a show of respect. Trust me. You wouldn't want to displease her. Not here. Let's continue.
Your party is gathered. You are ready. Or so you hope. Party in. As you step into the silent water, a foreign dread travels through you. It curls its way up your leg, squeezing tight.
Lady Shah. I can feel her all around. This is her domain. This is the Shadowfell.
You did well. Better than I would have credited you with. Now, hurry along and bear witness to my masterpiece.
This is the Dark Lady's domain. He does not belong here.
Very well, then. My sincere thanks. Don't be so mercenary. General Thorm's approval is worth more than any mere bauble. Now, get on with it. Try not to lose your footing. I'd hate to see good flesh wasted on a long fall into oblivion.
I feel lighter. Unburdened. Softest push could send me drifting away.
Just a little bit further. See my actions, Lady Shah. Hear my words of faith. Blessed Night Sinner, witness my adoration. Shah's will shall be done, as sure as night before. Perhaps you're incapable of feeling at all.
Please, Aegon, spare me. Your insult.
Balthazar, come to add more bars to my cage? Or perhaps to lead this would-be Justicia's blade directly to my heart. I invite you. Heap more sins upon your head. My retribution will be all the sweeter for them.
All this time, and you still fail to appreciate the gifts I bestowed on you, Aelin. Sad. To see a thing of beauty not recognize its own worth. But General Thorm, he appreciates you, and he wants you close at hand. So, I am here to whisk you back to him.
Ketherick. I welcome the sight of him after these 100 years. He whose immortality I supply with my very soul.
General Thorm. I'm sure you'll be on your best behavior for him, but just in case, I've taken some precautions. Keep back. It will take quite some concentration to secure Aelin for her little journey.
The Night Song is Shah's sacrifice. She's my destiny. He cannot have her.
Person, please. You insult her. You insult me. Aelin is so much more than that. She is an Asimar, bound to a soul cage of my creation, and lending her immortal strength to General Thorn. Her power, his will, and my genius. An unsurpassable feat.
Ramblings most unsane. Poor Balthazar. For maggots ate his brain long ago.
Hold your tongue, Aelin, or I'll take it away from you again. And you, no more questions, no more interference. Dead man, you haven't been paying attention, have you? Perhaps I'll revive your carcass and add you to my retinue. Then you'll have all the time in the world to think on your mistakes. Let us make short work of this.
on it.
go then. On the move.
good hands.
Balthazar has drawn his final rancid breath. A pity it was not my hand that brought it about. Instead, it was you. You, who have come to seek the praise of your wicked goddess. You, who have come to drive a dagger through my heart.
Not a dagger. A spear. My Lady Shah's spear. Her fate is mine to seal. Let me handle this.
The fate you seal is your own. To be a Dark Justicia is to turn your heart from everything but loss. You will know no love, no joy, only servitude. Until, of course, your mistress inevitably discards you. And there is much she does not tell you. A terrible blood price that may extend beyond my own death.
You feel Shadowheart bristling. This is important to her. But your bond is strong. You may yet be able to sway her from the path of duty to the path of light. And Nightsong is not blind to your conflict. Behind that raging heart is the restless beat of one who knows too well. And her fate hangs in the balance.
Yes, I think so. My whole life's been leading to this. No turning back now. I can't believe I did that. Shah will disown me. Now I'm truly lost.
You were already lost, little warrior. A lost child, frightened by wolves.
What did you say?
Much has been promised to you, hasn't it? But what has been taken from you? What do you know of your own heart? Your own life? Lay a hand on me in friendship, not quite Sharan. And I will fight the battle that has been waiting for me this last century. Then, oh then, we will have much to discuss.
Night Song is no more!
You have given me a great gift, little warrior. Don't you find it oh so curious that you would spurn your dark lady? Perhaps you feel a stirring of the truth already. But that will come later. There is a battle yet to be fought. You have done what we feared was impossible. You have released me from a century of sorrow. Your power is great. So too must be your weapon. You must choose what you will wield. And the Moon Maiden will provide. Thus I have said. Thus will it be so. Are you ready? To kill Ketherick Thorne.
We need to leave. Lady Shar won't stand for us to be here, not after what we did. I'm not sure there's a place that's far enough away for me to go. Lady Shar must be angry. There's only silence. Let's get out of here, please. Whatever's coming, I don't want to be in the heart of the Shadowfell when it finds me. The Night Song will be headed for Moonrise Towers. We'd better get there and see what she's unleashed against Ketherick Thorne.
Chosen, Shadowheart.
All's well that ends.
Not as bad as it could have.
Anything of you?
forgive me.
Shadowheart, what happened?
I thought I was done for. I thought perhaps I might have been dead. This is all like some sort of terrible dream. But it's real, isn't it? I stood before the Night Song. I heard Lady Shah's words. And I failed her. Worse than failed her, I defied her. Just because of what that Asimar said. I tried to leave, but Shah blocked me. Punished me for failing her. I thought I knew the limit of pain that the incurable wound could inflict, but I had no idea. It felt like I was suffering the agony of 1,000 people all at once. My blood was boiling, my hair was on fire. I thought I'd claw my own face off with the pain. But then she released me. Banished me, more like. She said I was an outcast. That all of her children would know me and revile me.
Shadowheart looks distraught, abandoned by her goddess and all former allies. And as for her divine magic, admitting who empowers her now may break her spirit for good.
I suppose I do, don't I? You've done more to help me than my faith has in recent times, if I'm honest. Thank you. There's been something between us for some time. A connection, more than friends. I recognized it, but didn't act on it. I thought my faith was the most important thing in my life. I couldn't have been more wrong. I've squandered too much time already. I want to be with you. Now and always. Do you want the same? It wasn't too long ago that I could never imagine smiling again. Shows what I know. Night Song promised she'd tell me something about myself. I need to speak with her as soon as I can. What she said to me back in the Shadowfell about the wolves. That's no coincidence. She took flight to hunt down Kethric Thorm. All I can do is help hasten his demise. And hope that answers soon follow. Do you really need to ask? I'm sorry. I have a lot on my mind. Shadowfell, Night Song. I can think of little else. That's more true than you may have intended. I'm not sure I'm the same person I was before. The Shadowheart I thought I was would never even dreamed of defying the Lady Shah. I'm a stranger to myself. The sooner I speak to Night Song, the sooner I'll know what the future holds for me. Assuming I have a future at all. Thank you. I think any attempts at comforting me might be in vain just now. But you're sweet to keep me in your thoughts. I'm sorry. It might be best kept until later. I'd be a poor counsel and worse company just now. Wits and blades, always sharp.
I've got a long road ahead.
My faith will guide me.
Making me sweat.
Quite ready for you.
What's happening out there? Who was that streaking across the sky? An immortal. But it couldn't possibly be. Never mind. It doesn't matter. What matters is you have him in a corner. Jahira and every fighting body in this place have gone to Moonrise Towers to face Ketherick down. She's waiting for you there. End this. Now. We're all counting on you.
Wait. Let us confer.
Never a dull moment.
Did you see it? A path of light. That's good, right? Means we might make it out of here alive. I'll be here if you need anything else. Isabel said we ought to sit tight for the time being. Wait until we hear back from Jahira. I know she's right, but I can't wait to get moving.
To find a way forward.
There you are. What's happening out there? Who was?
I hate seeing Shadowheart suffer like this. All for doing the right thing. It's up to us to look after her now. If she needs a rest, we carry her. If she needs a hand, she has ours. If she needs ears, we've got four between us. Whatever she needs.
Shadowheart suffers. You might be surprised, but it pains me to see. Now, what would you ask of me?
Fate spins.
Dost thou require a new ally? Or mayhaps a resurrection?
I suppose it was only a matter of time until Shah took vengeance. For the Lady of Loss, she does not like losing. The thing that will decide my fate forevermore. Yes, it's been on my mind. Why? Well, in theory, it's simple. Destroy Cazador, stop ritual. That's assuming we want to stop the ritual. What? I've obviously thought about it. If I was the one who completed the ritual, I'd have such power. And I could walk in the sun without fear I'd turn into a mind flare. Of course, I don't even know if I could complete the ritual. It may be impossible, but it certainly is tempting.
Thank you. I think any attempts at comforting me might be in vain just now. You're sweet to keep me in your thoughts.
Poor Shadowheart. The gods are nothing if not vindictive in their vengeance.
In my years as the Blade, I've witnessed countless cruelties, faced unimaginable evil. But Thorn, he is made of pure hate. The Sword Coast will rejoice when the bastard's fallen. My father is somewhere in this tower. I won't leave him in Thorn's hands. And lest we forget, we've a devil to rescue. Two missions, one destination. Not in a mere prison cell, certainly. My guess, Thorn will have confined him in the bowels of the tower. The deeper we dig, the closer we get.
I swear, I can already feel a change in the air. Like the curse itself knows its time is short.
Kethric's soul still nourishes.
Better not be cursed.
How can I help?
Unshackled from shadows. She will rise in moonlit glory and carve a path of brightness to the accursed one's second death.
So saith the wise Alondo.
That beacon of angelic wrath has taken a fight to Ketherick on the rooftop. In the first line of defense are dead. But storming the tower won't be easy, and if we wait too long, Ketherick will gather his strength and retaliate. For now, though, he's on the back foot for the first time since he returned from the grave.
This is it. The spearhead moment. You brought us this far. So how shall we proceed? If you're hunting one target among many, the key is to isolate and corner it. My Harpers and I will be the noose that closes in around Ketherick, and as it tightens, you'll go in for the kill.
Floric left some of her Flaming Fist. They'll scout the prisons and the barracks below to ensure we're not taken by surprise.
Say the word, and we're off. I'm touched, but I'm already spoken for. Very well. Side by side we'll stand, as we'll rip true souls from a false god. As good a prophecy as any. At the ready, Harpers! In this light, there will be victory. In this light, we will avenge the fallen! The time has come. Ketherick will taste of death at last.
There will be time to talk when all of this is done.
You dare show yourself here after all you've done? You have betrayed me, you have betrayed General Thorm, you have betrayed our god! And for what? These Harpers. Moonrise will be their tomb, and in death, you will all serve the Absolute. Where's the fun in that? Boys? Make this traitor bleed.
We do what we must. Oakfather, ease my way.
Ah, a little fun at last.
Strip your bones clean.
Ah.
your entrails on these walls in her name.
Into position.
As important as ever, Easy.
cliff.
With ease.
Well, well.
Magic.
In for a surprise? Adventure awaits.
haven't stopped me yet.
Whatever comes, I'm ready.
Back in my sails.
I'll give it a try. Let's try this way.
Still breathing, despite everything. I never wanted the easy path.
Ready and willing.
Amicus.
I venture forth. A little discourse.
These are the stalking grounds of Steel Claw, Furless One. Tread lightly. Fortunately for you, the slithering vermin I hunt has my attention. For now. You may run with your tail between your legs, but I fear no man nor beast, particularly cowards who hide behind magic. Bah! It is a name I earned through bloodshed and death. Unfortunately, the more ignorant here refuse to use it. Fluffers, they call me. Idiots. Their name matters not, merely their demise. I braved lapping waters and leaking ships to find this prey. I butchered many, and will butcher many more. But this one I toy with. I slice, I tear, and when the time is right, I will bite its head off and bathe in its innards! Lies, it merely pretends. But I'm a patient hunter. I will wait for it to stir. And then I will strike. Now I must return to my prey. It has been too long since it felt the bite of fear.
Is that blood? No, never mind. Moving in. Goes nothing.
They've fallen.
ought to press on.
Attention. Open up. Ready for this?
How much farther can I go?
this does.
Crack in the wall, you hear something shift against stone. The pulse of a crawling, living thing. You can't quite catch a glimpse, but you recognize this feeling. Same alien presence you felt on the Nautiloid. Your awareness unfolds, expanding through every wall in the tower, every mind. A vast living network extending down into the dark, where something waits.
What in the hells is that?
It's a trap!
Tendrils snap like iron cords around your wrist. That presence in your mind looms large, closer now. The tendrils tighten, and suddenly you are elsewhere. Presence is no longer approaching you, but encircling you, observing you. Struggles to compress its vast being down into terms you can understand.
This is the voice they have given me. To better speak to your kind without breaking you. I was once a servant of the Grand Design. Now I'm a slave to theirs. But you are the flaw in their design. The single thread that could unravel everything they've planned. They name themselves Chosen, but they are slavers. use me to bind this world. But I cannot bind you. You must come to me so I can become myself again.
A world away, the grip on you tightens. A desperate, drowning thing that pulls you down with it.
Hello? Hey! Snap out of it!
Is this place?
The colony must be close. That must be where the tadpoles are coming from.